Welcome back to part two of our soccer special. This time the action comes from Goodison Park. It's Everton against Leeds United. Commentator Clive Tilsley.
Colin Harvey starts the season without three men central to his plans, Peter Beadry, Tony Cotty and Ian Snowden. But Stuart McCall is fit to join Mike Milligan in midfield. Dave Watson and Martin Keown is the new firm at the centre of the defence. So Kevin Ratcliffe is left out of an Everton team for the first time in 8 years. That's how long Leeds United have been out of the first division. But of today's lineup, only David Batty and Gary Speed are actually new to the top flight. Former Everton striker Imari Varadi gets his chance in the absence of the injured Bobby Davison. Referee Kieran Barrett has a new rule book this season. Red cards for professional fouls, a more lenient offside law and compulsory shin pads. High hopes are the order of the day everywhere today. And no two teams have higher hopes than Everton and Leeds. Even Neville Southall has to pull his socks up under the new regulations. Made a short start, Andy Hinchcliffe at fullback. He'll be tested by Gordon Strachan this afternoon, that's for sure. Everill just gave himself a bit too much to do there. Away by Chris White. Neither club has been exactly eased into the season by the fixtures computer. Leeds have landed Manchester United this coming Tuesday, Spurs and Arsenal soon after. Arsenal and Liverpool are both on Everton's schedule for the opening month. No time for a practice lap in the championship race. Sterling's throw. Chapman waiting. Strachan. Away by Keown. This is McAllister. As Walker bounced that, he killed it well on the chest. Three waiting in the middle. Watson up above Chapman. First corner of the game to Leeds United. Chris White is forward inside the six-yard box with Lee Chapman. Chris Fairclough, his central defensive partner, is in there too. Way by maybe the smallest man in there, Mike Milligan. David Batty. Varadi. Keown attacked the ball and did just enough. Chris White, McDonald in. Early pressure from Leeds. Throw in which Gary Speed will take. White and Fairclough have stayed forward. Batty coming over to take the throw. Chapman the target, might bounce through, White's there, Fairclough's there, Leeds in front, Chris Fairclough. They're back in business. Leeds United's return to the first division is 6 minutes old and Chris Fairclough has given them the lead. Lee Chapman caused the problems at the near post. Everton committed a lot of men to guard with him, and the two central defenders were left free. Chapman, number 9, caused so many problems just by his sheer physical presence. Southall tried to close down White, but Fairclough was in. McAllister has made another good run forward, committing Keown. McCall. Looking to release Pat Nevin. Glyn Snowden in charge. Such a confident start. Both of these clubs so hungry for success. Famished, really. Here's Strachan. From Chapman's knockdown. He was allowed the shot at goal. Keown couldn't get to him. He's such a box of tricks. Everton encountering choppy waters in the opening stages of what's already a fascinating match. Watson's free kick to Andy Hinchcliffe. Cut out by Batty. Sterling looking for Chapman. And he's a big and easy target to find. Just behind Strachan. Varadi trying to resurrect it. Good play by Stuart McCall. Newell. McCall had never stopped running. Lukic has come out and just about managed to force the ball against McCall and away. Milligan. Caught late by McAllister. Lukic, having decided to come, had to keep going, and he was lucky with the bounce, really. It could have gone anywhere when it hit McCall. Milligan trying to let it run for Nevin, but Snowden was in sharply again. McCall, Newell, Sharp, Everett free on the left. Oh, and he almost caught Lukic out. It was a smart save by the post in the end. Element of surprise about John Everett's shot. And Lukic only just managed to recover his ground at the last moment. Looked to all the world as if there would be a cross here. Just a touch. Flicked on by Keogh, Watson turned against the crossbar by Lukic. Chapman back there, Lukic again, McCall! Escape for John Lukic. Hasn't looked altogether happy when the ball has been played across the face of his penalty area. Two central defenders combined well there for Everton. Keogh got the flick on, but it's Dave Watson with the header. And I think Lukic just got the first touch against the bar. McCall had the final shot, sliced. A little bit of encouragement for Everton. A sign of the times that the biggest threat posed in either penalty area has been by visiting central defenders. White back in his more normal role. First lecture of the afternoon. It's like he's been visiting his hairdresser daily this week. Nevin will take the free kick. Sharp's the target this time. There was an appeal for handball there against Chris Fairclough, and the linesman says penalty. Confirmed by the referee. But it was the signal of the linesman, Jet Banwell, which convinced Kieran Barrett to point to the spot. Graham Sharp appealed immediately, and Fairclough definitely handled it. No question about it. He just held the ball away with his right hand. Good decision. And good teamwork between the officials. Now, John Lukic saved a penalty on the opening day of last season at Old Trafford from Brian McClare. Didn't do Arsenal much good. Neil McDonald faces him this time. Consolation you can offer for a man who misses a penalty by that margin. A lot to think about for Messrs Power, Gabriel and Harvey there, the Everton think tank. Dangerous to let the ball bounce there. Watson down, Strachan, and another shooting opportunity for Leeds. Well, Everton are winning the initial headers, but they're just serving to tee them up for Leeds midfield players. run off it. Milligan unable to retrieve it. Speed. Batty making the run in behind Keown. Good goalkeeping by Neville Southall. So decisive, and somehow he came up with the ball. But the Leeds midfield is bubbling. And once again, Everton undone by the late run from midfield. David Batty getting beyond Martin Keown. Watch Southall here. Not only does he stop it, he catches it. White's there again. Needed help from Fairclough. Still battling away. But it's not a battle that Everton are winning. Varadi trying to make something of it. Southall came eventually. Varadi barged into him. Play on, says the referee. It's a goal. Gary Speed has forced the ball in, and Leeds are two up. Speed gets the congratulations. Everton, I fancy, will be unhappy about the challenge on Varadi, or maybe about the manner in which the ball eventually found its way into the goal. Varadi has paid a price for his bravery, but he's got his reward. Now there's Varadi closing in on Southall as Keown scampers back, and Keown was holding Varadi, if anything. And was it McDonald or was it Speed who got the crucial touch? I don't think there was any question of a foul on the goalkeeper here. If anybody hit him, it was Keown, the defender. And I have a fancy that Neil McDonald has scored an own goal to go with his penalty miss. Late challenge on Mel Sturton there by John Everill after the ball had gone. Very out of character for the England under 21 skipper. They can continue with a free kick for Leeds. We're 3 minutes over the 45. Well, a lot of Everton's disappointment will inevitably be directed towards number two, Neil McDonald, as he leads the field. A missed penalty and an own goal. But in truth, Leeds United have been the better side in the first half. Chris Fairclough, number five, gave them an early lead. And it's one that's really been threatened aside from the penalty. And at half-time, it's Everton 0, Leeds United 2.